Brothers and sisters, Surah Al-Ahzab, Surah number 33 of the Quran. You and I know that in Islam, we cannot just do what we want in terms of dress. We have to dress in a specific way. We have to follow rules and regulations. We have a uniform. Although that uniform is very broad, and although the rules and regulations governing the dress, they are actually quite broad and they are quite easy to fulfill. But there are rules. We cannot just do as we wish, because we call ourselves Muslimin. And if we do as we wish, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that you will have to pay for the choice you've made. You know, people today say, I'm free to do whatever I want to do. Technically, you are right. You are free. But the choice you make will come at a price. Remember that. You will have to pay for it either in the dunya or the akhirah or both. So when you make a decision, you might be free to make that decision as a human being. You chose how you want to dress, how you want to talk, what you want to do, what you want to eat. You chose what you want to engage in. You chose the prohibitions you want to do and the obligations you want to stay away from. Fair enough, the choice was yours, but you are answerable. You are responsible. You will pay for how you have chosen. Therefore, choose wisely. So one of the issues made mention of in this beautiful surah is a piece of advice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to issue to his family members, to the women, to his wives, his daughters, and the believing females. So it is not just a piece of advice, but in fact an instruction. So Allah says, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu, O messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qul, say to whom? لِأَزْوَاجِكَ وَبَنَاتِكَ وَنِسَاءِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ Say to your wives, to your daughters, and to the believing women, يُدْنِينَ عَلَيْهِنَّ مِنْ جَلَابِيبِهِنَّ That they should cover themselves with an outer garment. They should cover themselves with an outer garment. This is referring to when you are emerging from the home. You throw over yourself an outer garment. It's an instruction, verse number 59 of Surah 33, Surah Al-Ahzab, where Allah is saying to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell your wives, tell your daughters, and tell the believing women that they have to throw on themselves this outer julbab. Julbab meaning you have your dress, you are wearing your clothing as you emerge from the home, or you are in the presence of those who are strange, etc. You throw over a cloak or you throw over an outer garment in order to conceal your beauty. Now this is the rule of Islam, subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ أَدْنَىٰ أَن يُعْرَفْنَ فَلَا يُؤْذَيْنَ The reason behind this is so that you can save yourselves from harm, so that you can be recognized as Muslim women, as chaste women, as women who are not out there free for all, so to speak, and women who are serious about their modesty and chastity. Now, this is an Islamic ruling. Like I said before, we are governed by Islam. There may be people around us who are not governed by the same rules and regulations. Let them do as they wish. But we do as we are taught. Like I've said before, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen us. It's not so easy. It's not so easy at a time when Islamophobia is across the globe, at a time when people are looking at Muslims with the eye of suspicion. It's not so easy to dress as a Muslim woman. But for those who do, remember, they will save themselves from calamity, disaster in this world and the next. It might seem like it's tough and difficult, but wallahi, the more we are in number, the better the message we deliver to say we are peace-loving, we are beautiful people, we will reach out, we will help, we will assist, we have good character, we have conduct, we are a nation that is filled with goodness and morality and conduct. We are not bad or evil. But when we hide our identity, who would then know that we are Muslim when we do a good deed? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us acceptance. So this is called the verse of hijab. And it is reported that the women from amongst the Ansar, subhanallah, when this verse came out, they used to cover themselves with a cloak or with an outer garment that would actually be non-attractive in its color, in order for them to fulfill this particular verse. Now one might say, what exactly is the ruling? The ruling is quite broad, to be honest with you. It's quite broad. There is no specific color. There is no specific material, but it is something that would cover you. It is something that would ensure that you have come across very modestly, etc. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant our women and men the ability to cover themselves in a respectable way that would be, inshallah, pleasing to our own maker, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
First, I want to tell you that I'm a Muslim. I believe in everything written in the book of Allah and Al-Quran and in everything he said. But unfortunately, I find difficulty to convince myself with the Farida of Hijab. Do you have any advice concerning this? I wish that you could assist me and many of my friends.
Okay.
Thank you.
Jazakallah khair for your honesty. May Allah reward you for your honesty. And this is the first step to solve any problem, is to be honest, to admit I have a problem, to admit I have a difficulty. If a person doesn't even admit they have a difficulty, they will never be able to solve the problem. Let me remind myself and you that to commit a sin is one thing, but to justify a sin is much worse. To commit a sin is not good, it's bad. But to justify a sin is a million times worse. If I'm committing a sin, suppose, a'udhu billah, suppose somebody is smoking or drinking, and he says, oh, I know I'm a sinner, may Allah forgive me. This is not good, at least though he's being honest with Allah. And when you're honest with Allah, there is hope for forgiveness. When you're honest with Allah, at least there's a chance of repentance. The Prophet ﷺ said, feeling guilty for a sin is the essence of repentance. An-nadamu tawbah. Feeling guilty means you know you're committing a sin. You know you're committing a sin. This is the essence or the first step to repent from that sin. So make sure if you are committing a sin, that you don't justify that sin. Because justifying the sin is something that is very, very dangerous. Extremely dangerous. And that really lowers that rank that we have with Allah infinitely. Secondly, you ask, I have difficulty about the fariḍa of hijab. I remind you that the concept of hijab is a concept that is found very explicitly in the book of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, and very explicitly in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says in the Quran that let the believing women, وَلْيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَى جُيُوبِهِنَّ. Allah says in the Quran that let the believing women draw their khumur over their juyub. And khumur is the plural of khimar. And khimar is the Arabic word for that which covers your head. In English we call it a headscarf. So Allah is saying, let believing women draw their headscarves over their juyub. And juyub is their chest area. So Allah is saying, take your headscarf and make sure that you cover even your chest with the headscarf. This is very explicit in the Quran. There's no ambiguity here. Many people now are saying, where does the Quran say we have to do hijab? These people are people who have never read the Quran. It's right there in front of them, black and white. It's right there. Allah says, let believing women put their headscarves and cover their necks with it. Why is this? Because some women, listen to this, some women in the days of Jahiliyyah, they would cover their hair, but they would take their headscarf and throw it behind their back, and they would expose the upper chest. They would expose the upper chest. You know how the dresses are in our times, the low blouses that are common in the Western attire. In front of other women, that is something else. But in front of men, no woman can wear something like this. So Allah is saying, even if you wear a headscarf, make sure you cover the front part of your body as well. Don't just take a headscarf and throw it behind you. Take the headscarf and put it in front of you. So the Quran is very clear. And realize, my dear sisters, that this concept of modesty is something that Allah is doing not just for our protection, but primarily for yours. Allah says in the Quran that let believing women wear their coverings and garments. Why? ذَلِكَ أَدْنَا أَنْ يُعْرَفْنَا فَلَا يُؤْذَيْنَ. That is better for them. Allah is saying, for you to wear your scarf, for you to wear your covering, it is better for you. Allah is saying, why? So that they will be recognized and not taunted, not humiliated, not become the object of teasing and of evil things. فَلَا يُؤْذَيْنَ. So my dear sister, realize that this protection that Allah wants from you, it is to protect you, not only to protect the rest of society, but to protect you. Also realize that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam praised modest women, and he praised women who guard their chastity and who guard their beauty that Allah has given to them. And he also was not happy. In fact, in some ahadith, he cursed those women who flaunt their beauty. In one hadith he said, those women who do so, they will not smell the fragrance of paradise. In another hadith he said, these women who flaunt their beauty are of the signs of the day of judgment. This is of the signs of the end of times, that women will lose modesty. And in another, all of these hadith basically, they tell us the positive of covering, the positive of being modest, and the negative of being immodest. My dear sister in Islam, let me remind you of a blessing that all of you here take for granted. It is a blessing of living in a Muslim land and a Muslim country. I come from America. That's where I live. That's where my home is. That's where my family, everybody is there. For a sister to wear hijab in America, it's not easy. Especially post 9/11. I know. We know this as Muslims living there. My own wife has been threatened, ridiculed. People mock her. People look at her and stare. There's something strange. They'll give sarcastic comments. Sometimes even if I'm with her, they might just give an evil remark or something like this. It's not easy practicing Islam in Western lands. And yet, we find that alhamdulillah, hundreds and thousands of Muslim men and Muslim women are rediscovering Islam in the West. You go to Islamic conferences as large as these, nay, even larger than this, and you find, mashallah, brothers upon the sunnah, sisters are wearing hijab. They are doing so despite the problems living in the West. My dear sister, Allah has blessed you to live in the East. Allah has blessed you to be amongst Muslims. No one will make fun of you if you wear a scarf. No one will ridicule you. No one will give you threats. No one will think anything strange of you. This is a Muslim society. You're living amongst Muslims. You hear the adhan. You're mixing with people who believe in Allah and His Messenger. What is possibly preventing you from this level of excellence? What is there preventing you from coming closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ya ayyuhal insanu ma gharraka bi rabbika al-kareem. Why are you deceived? Something so simple, so straightforward, living in a society of people who are believers in Allah and His Messenger. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the strength and the courage, and He gives all of us the strength and the courage and the iman to live like Muslims, to act like Muslims, to behave like Muslims. This is only by doing this, and only by being proud to be Muslim, will the pride that Islam deserves return. My dear sister, I ask you a blunt question. If you are embarrassed about being a Muslim, if I'm embarrassed about being a Muslim, then is it any confusion? Is it any wonder that Islam has become something to be embarrassed about? The day that you are proud to be a Muslimah and I am proud to be a Muslim, that is the day that Islam itself shall regain its pride. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who bring that pride back. Wa jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.